And I did another internship for BASF, which is the largest, was and still is the largest chemical company in the world. And that I work on simulation of the process to produce polyethylene, which is the polymer of our plastic bag.
Okay.
And that was, so when I worked for EADS, I didn't find that very challenging, very interesting. I realized that they were using some material already developed by others. They were not doing much research. But when I worked for BASF, I went for BASF because I wanted just to learn more German because I was in Germany and I wanted an experience overseas. And in our school, it was mandatory to go overseas anyway as one internship. So I went to Germany because of the experience, but then I realized that really the way BASF was developing materials was really fascinating for me, trying to understand the synthesis, understanding the properties.
So is that when your interest shifted more away from planes into just material science?
These two internships, realizing that in fact, in terms of material science, the plane industry was maybe not the most innovative because there is a safety thing. So, if you do a very new material that looks really great, before you put it on the plane, it has to be heavily tested. Well, you can put it on the car with a lot less risk. If you break on the car, depending on what it is, there is limited consequences. Anything that breaks on the plane can lead to disaster. So in fact, in terms of new materials, the airplane industry is a lot, has to be a lot more conservative, which kind of makes sense. But I did realize that while the chemical industry is really the one driving it, so innovation. So what is developed by the chemical industry is very often used, 10 years later for the car industry and 20 or 30 years later in the aerospace industry. So developing materials is really done by a chemist in really, really chemical companies,
You said that you're looking at simulations of polyethylene. Can you elaborate on that?
So
What's that
they
mean?
had a very big reactor. So the process since the 1940s used to do the plastic bags. They got what they call a tubular reactor. So it's a reactor which is not very big, but very, very long, kilometer long, with a monomer, the ethylene going in, and they keep on putting some molecule with start the polymerization, some initiators. And that's kilometer long. And
How many kilometers long?
well, it depends how much they produce, but the pilot plant they had at BASF at the time was already several kilometers. And the industry one, I think, can be several times 10 kilometers. So it's like going on itself. So it's very long. And so they had big safety issues. That's if the reaction goes wrong because of the exothermic temperature increase, the reaction gets faster, and you can lead to what's called a popcorn effect. But when you have a kilometer long, you don't want to do popcorn with plastic, basically, because it's just lead to explosion. And there is something like 15 chemical reaction involved. So the worker on the plant have temperature measure everywhere, pressure. But sometimes when something goes wrong, they really need to react very, very fast. So it's very stressful. And also sometimes you just not for a human possible to react quick enough. So the idea was to have a computer simulation that can simulate all these 15 reaction and tell the worker in 1 minute it's going to explode there. So you need really to put the inhibitor or stop the reaction now. So to still having the process controlled by a person, but really, really help the person, what they call rectification. So that's the human operator can make the decision, having a real informed and quick decision.
So this kilometer or few kilometer long tube, you said you put the monomers, so there's a and as they go through this kilometer or so long tube, they react with other monomers, but they also have initiator chemicals that get them to join
Which
together.
form the big chain in the polymer,
So as it goes through this tube, at the end you get the polymers. Is that what
You get the
happens?
plastic, yeah.
Okay. And what you'd have the issue was that you'd have that popcorn effect somewhere in the middle, and then the whole thing would get clogged up, and then
Clogged or explode,
oh,
The
explode.
clogged is obviously bad, it's expensive, but you can really, really have, because you're under pressure and high temperature, if you start doing that, you clog it, the pressure may increase. If the pressure increase, the reaction is faster. The temperature increase because of the exotherm, the reaction is faster. And so you vaporize everything. And so if you vaporize everything very quickly,
That's
it's called an explosion.
explosion,
So it's something we don't realize, but and now I don't know where it is, But 20 years ago, the production of our plastic bag was still leading to casualties. Yeah, there were still some people being gravely injured, and from time to time, not like every day at all.
Yeah.
But the chemical industry had a few people killed, maybe a person every second year, or not very often. But some people were still dying on the chemical plant where things were going really, really wrong.
Okay, and now that's not the case, because
I think now it's a lot better. Yeah, because they got the computer simulation in place. Okay. So they can really see it coming.
Okay.
So they still lose a bit of money from time to time.
Right.
But I think in terms of accident, they're a lot safer. Yeah. That's one reason I think why our plastic bag, if you look, when I was a kid, and the plastic bag had been the same for a long time, people were talking a lot about, you know, there will be new plastic, even better, even cheaper. Mm-hmm. And finally, this polyethylene is still there. One reason is because we really control the process very well. Mm-hmm. So we were able to reduce the cost and produce it safely and get it stronger as well. The plastic bag looks the same. May have noticed that they go stronger with time. Mm. Now what you could see in the supermarket years and years ago, you know, that the people go with the plastic bag and it break. Now it's becoming very, very uncommon. So they look the same.
Right.
But if you are doing a mechanical test on it, and the old one, assuming you keep one from 20 years ago, you will see that it's even better. Yeah, not changing much, but you know, just
slight adjustment,
optimizing. Yeah, okay. Doing good optimization. Right. Yeah.